Hello GGC community, welcome back to our network of Grizzly Talk podcast, now streaming on Spotify, iHeartRadio, Google Podcast, and iTunes, along with Pandora and Amazon Alexa. As you can tell, I'm not Kennedy Patterson. My name is Ava Artis, a new host with Kennedy Patterson. He have asked me to come on the show while he and our film team are filming his next film, Storm of Okra. Let's get on to the news. Georgia Gwinnett College faculty are conducting a study that will shed light on familial coping strategies during the coronavirus pandemic. Study leads are seeking participants who will be asked a number of questions in a telephone interview lasting 60 to 90 minutes. The interviews will be conducted through July 31, 2020. Eligible participants include men and women between ages 18 and 67 with at least one other family member living in their household. Sociologist Emmy Cochran Jackson, PhD, is leading the research team. She said the team is particularly interested to learn how family dynamics are impacted in light of the pandemic. We want to get a better idea of what parents and families, both traditional and non-traditional, are going through during this time, Cochran Jackson said. The researchers hope to have the results available by December 2020. For questions, or to participate in the study, contact Cochran Jackson at ecochranjackson@ggc.edu. Citizens re-entering society after prison sentences face an uphill struggle finding work and basic resources under the stigma of being labeled an ex-convict. Georgia Gwinnett College students are making it easier for them to find the resources they need to rebuild their lives through a project with a Gwinnett nonprofit. A team of students collaborated with the Greater Gwinnett Reentry Alliance, GGRA, to create an interactive resource map for citizens re-entering society after prison. Three students in Dr. Jengi's Gunay software development class produced the software product for the GGRA over the course of 3 months this past spring. Gunay, an assistant professor of information technology at GGC, praised the students' drive to learn outside of class. "I didn't have to do much to motivate them," he said. Gunay accredited his students' motivation to their freedom to work at their own pace, learning and collaborating through direct interaction with a client. Gunay said the product was presented during a GGRA meeting in May and is now fully implemented on the organization's website. The project uses Google Maps in conjunction with an editable list of resources, making it easier to find housing, healthcare, job opportunities and transportation for citizens re-entering society. Joshua Sales, one of the students who worked on the project, said he and his group had to learn complex coding languages using Microsoft tutorials, textbooks and even YouTube videos with Gunay's guidance. Sales stressed how big an opportunity the project was for his group. "Helping ex-offenders is something I value," he said. "It was a rewarding project." Sales went on calling it a blessing to be able to help people while developing a portfolio of work. "Now, when we create a resume or speak in an interview, we can say we have software out there. That's not a statement a lot of students can make." GGRA Vice President Brandon Spar said his team is pleased with the finished product. "The interface is user-friendly," he said. "This was a very much needed resource." Moving forward, Spar said he will facilitate further projects between GGC and some of the GGRA's 24 partners. "We have several partners who would love to implement this kind of technology." Spar suggested technology that would streamline the intake process for volunteer work is another possible student-led project. "Most times people in need of services as well as people wanting to volunteer need to fill out a lot of paperwork and then someone has to process all of that paperwork. I see simple online portals with forms as being very valuable to a lot of our partners. These opportunities would allow more students to work on real-world projects for the community, helping Gwinnett, while building experience for the job market." Gunay's course focuses on group projects for clients outside of the classroom, giving students experience working in a professional environment. He places a special importance in students practicing communication with clients who don't have technical knowledge. The GGRA was founded in late 2014 in collaboration with the Gwinnett County Sheriff's Office, United Way and Prison Fellowship Ministries. It operates as a referral base and help hotline for citizens re-entering Gwinnett after prison, directing them toward resources for housing, health care, and other services. GGC began its partnership with the GGRA in 2017 through its association with GGC alumna Karen Collette, who now serves on the GGRA's advisory board. We hope you all enjoyed the show and find all information valuable. Until next time, I'm Ava Artis.